This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about increasing, decreasing, and constant functions. Let's start with an increasing function. If I draw a line like this, let's say this is the graph of a function, we say that this is an increasing function. In other words, as I move my finger from left to right along the graph, I'm also moving up towards the top of the graph, towards the top of the page. Another way to say this would be, as the x values get bigger, that happens when I move from left to right, the y values are also getting bigger. That happens when I move down from the bottom of the page to the top of the page. So if the graph is moving upward as we go from left to right, we say that's an increasing function. For a decreasing function, we've got the opposite thing happening. As we move from left to right, the graph would be going downward, going down towards the bottom of the page. So we're always talking about what happens when we go from the left side of the graph to the right side of the graph, from the negative x values to the positive x values. If we move down along that graph, towards the bottom of it, then we've got a decreasing function. If we move upward from left to right, we've got an increasing function. Now the third option would be if we have something called a constant function. In other words, if I have a line which is horizontal to the x-axis, like let's say this line at y equals 3, then this is a constant function. As I go from left to right, I'm constantly at the same level. I'm not moving up, I'm not moving down. I'm just on that line where y equals 3. Okay? So, constant function, it's horizontal. It's always the same level. Increasing function, we're moving upward from left to right. A decreasing function, we're moving down from left to right. Now, we might have a function which is increasing over some intervals and then decreasing over other intervals and maybe constant at some intervals. So we might have a function that looks something like this. We might start, let's say at this point, negative 6, 1, and go over to negative 2, 3. At that point, we might drop down, and we might go from, let's say negative 2, negative 1, and go, let's say, straight across. I'll try to make that straight across. Straight across until we get to this point, 3, negative 1. At that point, the graph may start moving downward. Okay, so what we've got here is a graph which starts out with an increasing interval, then it has a constant interval, and then it has a decreasing interval. We can express each of those intervals in interval notation. We started out at negative 6, 1. So I'm only going to concern myself with the x values. So when I go from negative 6, and that's including negative 6. So my interval notation is going to start with the square bracket. When I go from negative 6 over to negative 2, including negative 2, I've got an increasing interval. The next interval is a constant one. It begins just after negative 2. So I use a round parenthesis for that. And it continues over to positive 3, including positive 3. So that's where it's constant. After that point, it's decreasing. It's decreasing from 3, apparently, to infinity. Notice again, when I write the intervals to show where it's increasing or constant or decreasing. The only numbers I'm using are the ones that indicate the x values, the negative 6, negative 2 for the increasing, and then the negative 2 and positive 3 for constant, and then 3 and infinity for decreasing. Okay? So, once again, if you're going up from left to right, going uphill in a sense, then you've got an increasing function. If you're constantly at the same level, it's a constant function. If you're going down from left to right, then it's decreasing. You can show the different places where this is happening by using interval notation. Okay, hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.